This is a supplementary unit in case you've forgotten how sine and cosine and their friends work. You may directly skip to the quiz to check your knowledge. Sine and cosine and their friends are about right triangles. This is a right triangle, a triangle that has a right angle. A and B are the legs of the right triangle. C is the hypotenuse. And I'm interested in that angle, which I call beta. Once this angle is specified, the ratio of every two of these sides is fixed. For instance, B divided by C is fixed once beta is given. That's called the sine of beta. And A divided by C is given once beta is known. That's the cosine. If we have a different right triangle with the same angle beta, you see, in this case, the leg B shrinks the same ratio as the leg C shrinks. So this ratio B over C stays constant. Same for A divided by C. A shrinks, C shrinks in the same ratio. This ratio A divided by C stays constant. It's a function of this angle beta alone. In daily life, you would specify beta with angular degrees. 45 degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees. In mathematics and in most part of computer science, you do not use angular degrees, you use radians. The idea is the following. You look at the unit circle, circle of radius 1. If this is the angle I want to express, 90 degrees, I'm not using the number 19 degrees, but I'm giving the length of the part of the circumference that I'm cutting off here. The total circumference would be 2 pi, a circle of radius 1. So this would be pi divided by 2. And that's the angle in radian. 90 degrees become pi divided by 2. 3.14 and so on divided by 2. A very ugly number. If I want to specify 45 degrees, that's, of course, just half of that number, pi divided by 4.